Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. Now, this playthrough, I'm actually playing it on Daggerfall Unity, as you guys probably might have already gleaned from the title of this video. But I have actually modded this game out quite significantly, at least I think so, because this is the maximum number of mods that I've ever used for any game at one given time. I don't typically mod games, and that's probably showing right now. But so I basically followed this video guide on YouTube, uploaded by this person called, I don't really know how to pronounce the name, I think it's Jalar or something, but yeah, you spell it as J-W-L-A-R, and yeah, they have this video that they released back in 2022, but their mods are pretty comprehensive, and well, they are still compatible with Daggerfall Unity, so I went ahead and used his guide. I'll be linking that video down in the description, and you can actually head over to his video and look into his video's description to access his spreadsheet, which will actually have the links to all the mods that he's talking about in his videos, and it actually contains both enhancements that make the game look more vanilla but smoother, and as well as enhancements for the dream mod, which makes everything look more realistic and 3D. So for this playthrough, I'm actually using what he likes to call vanilla plus plus. So with that being said, yeah, this playthrough will be as a spellcaster. I don't really know whether to call myself a mage or whatever, but yeah, I will be primarily using magic, and I will attempt to keep myself equipped with only a staff to protect myself. So yeah, let's see how this goes. That's at least a staff and a dagger. Let's use a dagger as well, just in case, you know, because finding staffs of different materials is pretty difficult in this game. Maybe I'll have to install another mod for that just to get myself like an ebony staff or something. Let's see. Anyhow, let's go ahead and start a new game then. So I did a bit of research, and as it turns out, well, I can either go for like Morrowind here, be like a Dunmer and have like a boost to my chance to hit, or I could just go for magical resistance and decide to be a Breton from High Rock. So I guess I'll go ahead and choose High Rock, because magic resistance does help a lot in this game. Alright. Red Guards. No, I did not choose Red Guard, I chose High Rock. Yeah, that's better. Breton hailed from the province of High Rock. You are a part of a tall, fair-skinned people, highly intelligent and willful. Magic seems to infuse the very being of the Breton people. As a race, they are more resistant to the effects of hostile magic than they are any other group, and thus are excellent in all arcane arts. Is your character to be a Breton? Yes. Select thy character's gender. Now, because the previous time I played as a female, this time we're going to be playing as a male. And would you like to... yeah, I'm going to generate my own character's class. No. I'll be choosing this one. So I basically want to create a custom character. And what do we name it? Now, that is the question. Excuse me, though. Actually, I do want to. I don't exactly want to call him a mage or a wizard, because that's already a class in this, game. So I'm still thinking about what I could probably call this class. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah, I've got no idea. Let's just call him a mystic. Right. Now, everything is starting out at level 50 here. Primary skills, I would like to take destruction as a primary skill, and then follow it with other magical skills, such as restoration, I think. Yes, restoration right here. And then what else should we take? Destruction, Restoration. I would not like to actually... the thing is, when you're making these classes, you need to make sure that you do not put in your most, all of your most useful skills into one section. Split them up like two important skills with one skill that you won't really be using as much. So for, in my case, I will put Blunt Weapon here. Maybe, who knows, right? So maybe I'll put Blunt Weapon here, for example. Here I'll put, what can I put here? I can put, well, Thaumaturgy for one. There's Streetwise Swimming. Don't really want to put Swimming in there. Mysticism, that is another magic thing, I guess, yes. Illusion is one class that I would definitely like to put here. The second one would be, Dodging, Dragonish, Etiquette, Giantish, Hand to Hand, Harpy, Impish, Jumping, Lockpicking, Long Lead, Mercantile, Mysticism, Thaumaturgy, I guess. I don't really know what spells comprise any of these, classes, but yeah, I'm hoping that it will actually help. So for the rest, I'm just going to put Short Lead here, and I'm going to put Medical right here. Now, the way you set this up not only helps you level up better, but it also gives you boosts to how you can actually essentially how strong your skills are when you first start out. So yeah, that okay. What else? Alteration. Have we picked alteration for anything yet? I wonder. Alteration, actually we have not. So why don't we go ahead and put alteration here instead of Thaumaturgy, Mysticism. Yeah, let's put alteration here. We'll put Mysticism down here. I don't know what Mysticism does. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna butcher this right now, but yeah, let's hope that we'll be able to get better with time. That's essentially my end goal. Now, hand to hand, I do want to put it here because, well, or do I? I don't really know. Yeah. Jumping, Lockpicking, Long Lead, Mercantile, Pickpocket, Running, Spriggan, Stealth, Streetwise, Swimming. I don't really know what which all of these skills I'm actually going to be using. Axe, Giantish. A lot of these skills don't really seem all that useful for my character, to be honest. Mysticism, did I put it there? I think I did. So all of these are languages, and then there's, you know, athletic stuff like jumping. Might as well put it there because it will help us like level up anyway. So jumping, swimming, maybe? I'm mostly looking to use water walking and things like that, so I don't think I want to put swimming in there. Mercantile, Long Lead, Lockpicking, Impish, Harpy. See, these are the skills which don't really get leveled up as much, these very specific languages, because they only get leveled up when you face the certain enemy and the game just like this rule where it pretends that they've actually said something to you and you understood it. So with enough practice in these skills, you can actually get to where you can just diffuse a situation by talking and the monster will actually not fight you and just walk away. But yeah, getting there actually takes a lot of time and a lot of encounters with these monsters. So these skills are more or less useless. Running, of course, that's another skill there. I don't really see myself climbing a lot because since we're a mage, we'll be using Levitate for the most part. And what else? Critical Strike, Dodging. Maybe. Let's get like a minor boost to Dodging. That should definitely help. Now, skill advancement for classes right now, it's average. Now, strength, I would like to lower it. I do not have a lot of use for strength. I would like to instead put that into intelligence. Whoops. And personality, or luck rather. We can take a few points out of luck and put it into willpower. Now, agility is something that has, to my knowledge, been, how do I put this, rectified for this game. So, agility will actually impact your to hit or to dodge chance. So, it's better that you keep it high. Now, speed is also important, being the reason why I'm not putting it down so much. Endurance, because I need some carrying capacity and some health hit points, you know. Max hit points per level. Let's bump this up to like something like 20. And that already put our dagger up higher, you know, where it's like super easy, like rather difficult for us to advance in rank. I think right now it's 1.5 times or something the difficulty for us to advance as compared to the average class. So right now it's not exactly balanced, basically. So intelligence and will are starting out at 60. Maybe I should take a bit more luck out, because luck only helps with loot. And put it into half into willpower, half into agility. That makes sense. Now this, all this does, putting luck all the way down here, is it sort of opens me up to dying every time I get hit with a poison or some kind of curse which will impact my luck. So that is something that I want to avoid. So max hit points per level 20, added special advantages. Current special advantages, add all available advantages. Acute hearing, that is actually a disadvantage because it does not help you sleep well inside dungeons. Adrenaline rush, not really. Bonus to hit, I would like to add it. Yeah, nah. That's a very specific advantage which I don't really like as much. Now, I'm not really looking to use much weapons either, so we'll just leave this here. Athleticism, expertise, and immunity. Immunity to what, though? To disease? We could take this, actually. This is not bad. We could take immunity to disease or poison. We could pick like some immunities, but I think I'm going to take an immunity to fire. Or maybe I would rather take an immunity to shock instead. And that puts a dagger up way high. So increased majory, let's see, if 3 times spell points. Or intelligence and spell points. Now that is 3 times intelligence and spell points. Yeah, I'll take that. Maybe we will remove immunity to shock if that actually does not help us out. Rapid healing in general. Regenerate health. In darkness. Maybe we could actually go ahead and... yeah, let's remove rapid healing in general and reach rapid healing in darkness. Yes, let us keep it that way. Resistance. Immunity to shock, resistance to maybe fire. That makes sense, I suppose. Let's see, we'll add this first and then we'll go ahead spell absorption. Okay, in darkness, I'll keep it in darkness, spell absorption in darkness. That makes sense. Now, I think I'll keep it like this and we'll just go ahead and add all the stuff that we think might be useful. Try to balance it out using the special disadvantages. And no, I do not want to add any critical weaknesses here. Damage from sunlight or holy pieces, I do not want to be a vampire. Darkness powered major, yes. Unable to use magic in daylight. Lower magic. Now, I seriously want to hamper my... Like, I'm mostly making this build for combat, so... With that in mind, I'll go ahead and put this right here. Unable to use magic in daylight. Forbidden armor type, yes. There is a forbidden armor type that I want to impose on myself, and that would be, well, plate. Now the question is, why is this thing not dropping here? Forbidden material. Yes. So now the thing is, does this apply only to plate? I wonder. Now adamantium, dwarven, daedric, ebony, elven. Curious. Adamantium. Forbidden shield types. Yes, we do not want to use any shields whatsoever. So we're going to drop that, and we're going to drop this. And let us go ahead and take this away for now. Forbidden weaponry. We do not want to be using axes. Wait, is that the most amount of disadvantages that I can add? Well, I would definitely like to reconsider my possibilities then. Inability to regen spell points. Nope. Light power majory. No, that does not work. Low tolerance, phobia. Low tolerance to disease, low tolerance to... You know, since we are a mage, we could just go ahead and... use like a potion of reaction or whatever and get out of all of our... We could just cure ourselves essentially, is what I'm saying. So, low tolerance to diseases. Okay, forbidden shield types. Forbidden weaponry, axe. Now, I wonder what forbidden material. I'll definitely add something like Daedric here. But that actually did not lower this significantly enough. Forbidden material, adamantium. Again, actually that did lower it a lot. Forbidden material, silver. That seemed to have lowered it a bit, to be honest. Forbidden armor type is plate armor. I've forbidden myself from wearing it. I'm gonna only go for a chain at most. Because, well, everybody needs some level of protection. Light powered majory. I've already taken darkness powered majory. Light powered majory is actually... this is an advantage in disguise because you'll mostly be facing combat inside of dungeons or inside of buildings. So if you find enemies outside, just run. and yeah, inside dungeons, no matter how well lit it is always considered darkness. So yeah, that. What else can we add here? What other disadvantages can we add here? Regen spell points. Yeah, no, that's not what I really want to add. Like inability to regen spell points. Critical weakness. Yeah, I do not want to add critical weakness either. Damage, yeah, we've already been through that. Darkness powered majory, we have... Well... done that as well. So forbidden shield type is tower shield. Now adamantium. Maybe we can like skip a tier there. Maybe we can skip a tier or two there. And that is the maximum that I can add. Now like the question that I have to ask myself is whether this is wise or whether I should actually go ahead and choose something else. I do not want to like add any more low tolerances. Animals, tetra, humanoid, undead. Yeah, I don't know. That seems bad. Phobia is like a disadvantage. Like an actual D&D style disadvantage. So you'll suffer heavy penalties whenever you're fighting enemies of that kind. Forbidden material. Maybe. Now, I do plan on going into temple, so I cannot choose this, that's for certain. I could be like a nightcrawler of sorts, but that does not make sense. Critical weakness. Yeah, no, that's I've already added low tolerances. I do not want to add a critical weakness. Or maybe I can, actually. Maybe let's change these to critical weaknesses instead. That means that every time an enemy tries to paralyze us, or shock us, or poison us, they will always be successful, essentially. Maybe I'll add critical weakness to paralysis and... low tolerance to poison and low tolerance to disease. And what else can we add here? We need something else. Forbidden weaponry, we can use like the long blade here. That really does not make that much of a difference. Forbidden shield types. No, quickly want to check something here. That really does not give you a lot of disadvantages either. What else can we add? Phobia, low tolerance. To disease, to poison, to paralysis. Forbidden material, maybe let's, let's go ahead and eliminate Daedric from this list. And forbidden weaponry, because by the time that we actually get to forbidden material, because by the time we actually get to a point where we will be using these, our magic will be strong enough that will mostly be carrying us forward. So I do not think we really need to be carrying all of these. Orcish, forbidden material, Orcish, we are now going down. That is good. Critical weaknesses to paralysis, forbidden armor type plate. All right, added special advantages. All right. Immunity to shock, resistance to fire. Maybe we want to remove the immunity to shock and give ourselves a resistance to shock as well. Maybe that is the play here, because that seems to have brought it down a little instead of getting an immunity. Yeah, that seems to have brought it down a little bit. I don't know whether it's enough or not, but yeah. Resistance to shock. Yeah, it's a little bit of a difference. Resistance to fire and shock, because those are the two kinds of spells that will totally wreck you. And I do not want that to happen, to be honest. Okay, rapid healing in darkness. Resistance to fire. Regenerate rate health in darkness. Now, I don't really know the difference between these two. Rapid healing and regenerate health. What the difference is between these two. Spell absorption darkness, I would definitely love that. Our difficulty level is a little higher than average, but... we do need to level up. Well, the initial phase of this game is always pretty difficult, and we don't really know whether... we're right now at like a 1.75 times difficulty. For skill advancement, I don't really know whether that's a good thing or not, but well, it is what it is. And I think this is a decent enough starter build. Maybe we can put our personality down just a little lower as well. And yeah, let's put our personality to 30, start out with an intelligent, but not that good of a mage that, like an intelligent mage, but not exactly a personable one. So max at points per level, I could tune this down to 15, bring the difficulty a little lower, or maybe keep it somewhere here, like 18 hit points per level. I could like bump it up to like 50 as well and make it really difficult on myself. Oh, 30 is the maximum. All right, what's the minimum of my banter? Is it like 2 or something? Nope, 4. It's 4. That's gonna make things very easy for us, and 8 is a little too less, I think. But then again, that's what you get in D&D as well. Although I'm not sure comparing it to this game to D&D is something that's good. Thinking of everything, I mean, this does not seem that bad of a difficulty level here. Although I don't know whether I could edit some of my special advantages out. Like for example, rapid healing and regenerate health. I don't really know the difference between these two. Regenerate health and darkness, rapid healing. Maybe if we take this out, yeah, it doesn't really. While immersed in water and darkness, yes, rapid healing and darkness. Wait, I thought I. Yeah, Thank you. So it doesn't really help much. Repetitioning in darkness and regenerate health in darkness, 3 times intelligence and spell points. So we have got like a significantly large mana pool to begin with. Alright. And how do I proceed with this then? Do I exit? Or do I press enter here? I guess I exit. Oh no. Wait. Oh, I did not read that. I think that was the prompt for the quiz wherein I could have gotten that ebony dagger. I sort of want to go back and take it again. I'm going to name myself Strange Blood for now. What about the previous one? Maybe this one? This guy looks nice. Actually, can't I like, oh, so wait, those were like the starting stats. Alright, that's not bad actually. That is not bad at all. We've got like huge spell points. Right. Fast start by automatically generating character's background, starting attributes and skills within the character sheet. Choose your character's career path by answering 12 important career decisions. Yes, influence character background. So, yeah. What schools of magic have you been studying the longest? What school of magic? So, I'll go with destruction. Because I want my spells to be very powerful. What motivates into life, into a life of adventure? Now, I could go for fame here and get like a boost to my reputation. Or riches and get some gold. But gold is pretty cheap in this game. It comes very easily. I don't know what knowledge does. I honestly do not know what knowledge does. Fun? Again, I've got no idea what that is. Helping others? No clue. Maybe let's choose knowledge and see what we get. In between formal study, you spent your time socializing with aristocrats, learning street smarts, learning economics, sparring, practicing acrobatics, swimming. Good. Good question. Just give me a moment there. I wonder what this does, learning economics. This seems sort of interesting. Since childhood, you have saved Aquarius, a favorite book, a bow, and 100 gold pieces. 100 gold pieces is nothing in this game. How did I like save that since childhood? Maybe everything is just so damn expensive, inflation, my god. A bull, a favorite book, Aquarius. Now, the thing is, I cannot wear Aquarius unless it's like made of leather. So maybe we can actually use this. Because I have this mod installed which is called Usable Starting Equipment. It comes as a part of that package, and what it essentially does is it makes sure that the things that you're using, the things that your character gets at the very beginning of the game are things that your character can use. So, yeah. In gratitude for services rendered, the Emperor gave you over 200 gold pieces, a silver staff, a suit of armor, a ruby, and ebony dagger. Now, this is exactly what I wanted. And as you grew older, you received additional magical training in the School of Illusion, Thaumaturgy, Mysticism, Moderation, Restoration. I'll go with Restoration, yes. As a childhood, your nickname was Rabbit, Quicksilver, Monkey, Scrapper, Guppy. Now, this actually is a question about, what your skills. It will give you a boost to your skills. Like, this is like hand-to-hand. This is running. This is jumping. I don't know what this is. This is climbing. So, maybe this is framing. Who knows? But, I don't really know which one I want to choose from these. Maybe Scrapper? You're friendlier than most with the savage harpies, the glorious dragons. Infernal Daedra. Primitive centaurs. I've actually never faced a centaur in this game, come to think of it. The simple giants, the modest nymphs. Immodest. Because they swim around topless, I guess. The bucolic spriggans. Bucolic. Mischievous imps. Excuse me. Good question. I wonder which faction's language I would like to get more of a boost in. I mean, out of all of these options presented, Dragonlings are the worst. At least they were back in, like, DOSBox Daggerfall, the original OG Daggerfall. But that was primarily because of how they used to have this thing where instead of one spell, they would, like, spam three spells at a time. And that's what essentially made all spellcasters way too difficult in that game. Now, which one do I want to choose from these, I wonder? We face an imp right off the bat, but they're pushovers, actually. I mean, once you get, like, even slightly strong, they're pushovers. The only two out of this list that I can see ever being a threat are either Dragonlings or Daedra. So with that in mind, I'll take the Daedra. Making friends of Daedra, that is. Of all disagreeable types, you have the most personal hatred for sanctimonious priests, stupid peasants, immoral assassins, power mad robber barons, diabolical wizards. Now, this is a question about your reputation. Now, being a mystic myself, I cannot exactly hate diabolical wizards. Now, priests, again, I'm looking for temple quests in this. Peasants, maybe we can look down on the peasantry. Who knows? Now, assassins, I've got no reason to get friendly with assassins, but I am not going for that kind of a playthrough, so maybe we can just go ahead and choose this. You are intimate friends with a monk, a rogue, an assassin, a warrior, and a mage. Let's take a mage, perhaps. Yeah. What god, if any, do you worship? Zenithar, god of commerce. Dibella, goddess of beauty. Akatosh, god of time. Kynareath, goddess of air. Standard, god of mercy. Julianus, god of logic. Mara, the mother goddess. And Arke, the god of birth and death. Now, where's that guy? What's his name? Where's Talos? I worship Talos. Where's Talos? Being from Skyrim, of course I worship Talos. Maybe that isn't a canon event at this game. I mean, that should be a canon event at this point, because Tiber Septim, like Martin Septim and all, that entire bloodline came, like Uriel Septim the VII, we were actually interacting with him, and he only came to power because of Tiber Septim. So the question is, why is Tiber Septim not listed here? I feel like that's like an addition that was made like solely for Skyrim. But yeah, the lore was pretty young at this point in time in the game, so we cannot exactly blame them for that. And we don't really have any details of when Tiber Septim ascended to godhood in the eyes of the people. So they did put him up there with the nine divines, so that is for certain. Okay, so what god should we be choosing? Because see, if you decide to choose Kain, you'll actually gain access to spellmakers and stuff inside temples as well. So maybe I'll go with Kain. Maybe. That's like a very Nordic sort of, choice there that we're going to make. Maybe Akatosh. I feel like going for Akatosh because that guy is sort of, you know, I like Akatosh, I like dragons, and he's the god of time, so. But yeah, I think I'll go for Kain. Kynareath, in other words, you have most trouble resisting poisons, getting along with others, resisting magic, staying awake and alert. But this right here is pretty much a boon. Fighting without magic, avoiding diseases. Now I can, like, these actually will not lower the difficulty for me at all. Getting along with others, that's like a personality hit to your personality. Staying awake and alert, that is like a boon. So if you go ahead and select this, you'll be able to rest inside of dungeons even with monsters. Comparatively, like, not right in your face, but Typically, if the monster was a little further, yeah, you could, like, you know, with a monster comparatively close than a normal person, so I'm just going to go ahead and choose this. Common as merchants, yeah, unchanged. Reputation remains unchanged. Strange Blood, I'm going to name myself Strange Blood, as described before. And this guy looks amazing, but let's go ahead and look through the rest as well. All of these look like rascals, so I'm just going to choose this one. A very Nordic look there. Intelligence is 79, my god. So damage is minus 1. Okay, I guess we need that much strength to actually cause damage. Which leaves us with very few hit points to actually, you know, hit other people with. Luck, again, oh, I can't lure it anymore. That's sort of sad. Personality, endurance is nice. Maybe I have to pour the rest into endurance, because these two are my dump stats, essentially, at this point. I've got 237 spell points in magic, and magical resistance is 7. But to hit is 0, so maybe let's go ahead and... Yeah, that will not really increase my endurance or anything. But damage plus 1, maximum encumbrance is 82, and to hit is plus 1. Yay! That also means to dodge is minus 1, or plus 1 rather. 1 hit point, healing rate is 1. Okay, that we have officially made that 70. That works, I guess. I have a feeling I'm going to get wrecked in the starter dungeon itself. But yeah, let's go ahead with this loadout then. Or maybe we can make this an even 75, which did not do anything, actually. Which only gives us, like, yeah, might as well put it into speed in that case. Alright. Oh yeah, right, we get the option to do this as well. And yeah, destruction, restoration, blunt weapon. Seems fine, actually. Everything seems just fine, to be honest. I'll go ahead and distribute these two coins here. And illusion, thaumaturgy. Let's even it out first. And then just pour the points all willingly. Alteration, illusion, right. Short blade, because I am getting an ebony blade right here. And we're going to be pouring this, pouring our stats into, well, these things. Mysticism, though, I think I'll choose the short blade over the other two instead. Alright. Player reflexes determine the overall speed of the game. If you pick very high reflexes, the monsters will move and attack quickly, forcing you to be quick with the controls. Very low reflexes means the monsters will move and attack slowly, allowing you to adopt a more cautious, thoughtful playstyle. Your character will advance a little slower with the low reflex setting, and will advance a little faster with the higher reflex setting. Now here's the thing, I do not want to keep the reflex very high, but I'll keep it at high, because... yeah, I do want to negate that how do I put this? The disadvantage to leveling up that I got. Okay, so I think everything looks fine. And yeah, let's begin then.